Hi everyone, I'm Priya Mistry, the TMJ doc, and today I'm gonna show you guys how to release the lateral pterygoid muscle. The lateral pterygoid muscle is typically a key player in clenching and bruxing activity. And when this muscle becomes dysfunctional, it can cause a lot of pain. It can cause pain behind the eye, pain into the ear, jaw pain, headaches, even specific tooth pain, so much so that people think they have an infected tooth. So this muscle is little. It's about the size of the end of my pinky here, but it is fierce. And I call it the troublemaker, but I've heard it called the terrible, which I love because it's a playoff of pterygoid, but I did not come up with that one myself, unfortunately. So for those of you who don't know me, I'm a general dentist with a practice in beautiful Portland, Oregon, where we are dedicated to taking care of patients with TMJ disorders. I'm fortunate enough to be working with my mentor, Dr. Arthur L. Parker here. Please be sure to check out my Instagram as well. I post there quite frequently and there's a lot of tips, tidbits, fun information, fun facts for us TMJD geeks. So let's get back to the release. The lateral pterygoid muscle stretches from the sphenoid bone in our skull to the disc within the joint, as well as the condyle, which is the bony knob that our mandible terminates on. The job of the lateral pterygoid is to depress the mandible, to protrude the mandible, and to help with side-to-side movement. This muscle is quite difficult to reach, so I'll do my best to show you how to reach and release it on yourself at home. So if you're doing the left side, use your right hand and vice versa. So you'll use your pinky finger, preferably gloved because, well, COVID. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna take your finger and you're actually gonna turn it so that the nail faces your teeth. And you're gonna get your finger up as far back past the upper last molar, as far back and as far up as you can. It's probably going to be pretty tight in there and it's going to feel hard or knotted or like bone, and it's probably going to be pretty tender. That's kind of how you know you're in the right area, because this muscle, when it's angry, again, it's fierce. When you're back there, the pad of your finger will encounter bone. This is part of the mandible. That's the inside part of this ramus right here. So that's normal if you contact bone. So once you reach the spot, you're basically gonna apply pressure with your finger for 10 seconds at a time. This is basically a myofascial release. And then you can change the angulation or get deeper in there after each 10 second span. So you can change the angulation to access more of that muscle. As you do it, you may feel it opening up back there a little bit more. And each time, 10 seconds of pressure, try not to do too much. You'll kind of know when you've hit that sweet spot where it's just super painful versus you're actually getting a good release. Each time you change the angulation, apply pressure for another 10 seconds. And you can do that a few times. So maybe 3-4 different spots back there and then take your finger out. So you can do this 1-2 times a day. You don't want to overdo it. That muscle's probably already mad for most of us. I know it is for me. So again, this pressure when you're back there, it may hurt, but this signals to your body to bring fresh blood flow, which brings fresh oxygen to that muscle. And it also promotes lymphatic drainage. So any kinases, lactic acid, stuff that's built up in there that we don't want, it's promoting all of that to drain out of there. So there is a purpose behind this. It is a muscle release, but it also brings fresh blood flow and promotes lymphatic drainage. So let me go ahead and demonstrate on myself. I'm about to look really cool with my pink glove. And voila, here we go. So you're gonna take your pinky, you're gonna turn so that the nail, this part here, is facing your teeth and the pad of your finger is facing this way. Then you're gonna go as far back and up as you can and apply pressure for 10 seconds. Change the angulation, do it a few more times as you start to feel it open up a little bit more. So I'm not gonna do a full 10 seconds so you guys don't have to stare at me that long, but I'll do enough to give you guys the gist, okay? One last thing, before you actually go in your mouth, once you go in, open big, to access the spot, close down about halfway or more, and that opens up that cheek area back there. So watch, I'll open big to get my finger in, and then I'll close a little more than halfway actually to really allow my finger access, okay? Okay, so I'm right back here. All right, guys, so I hope that was helpful. It's hard to demonstrate that, but I did my best. So that's really all I've got for you guys today. If you like what you heard, if you learned something new, subscribe, like my channel, do all the things, and remember, you can never have TMI about TMJ.